Hello, denizens of the internet. It looks like I've experienced what the fandom menace looks like.
Too bad dislikes are removed. I was curious with the number. This sounds like a guy who hates anything that the masses deemed good. I'm curious now what genre and movies this guy likes. Probably shot no one would ever watch. Think they meant shit. Boomer take! Crazy old man, LOL. Yeah, I think he didn't even watch the show, just like I didn't watch this video. You're the only one boring here, not Arcane. This series sucked. Oh, someone who agreed with me. Chuck. Who's Chuck? Why is everyone calling me Chuck?
I know fandom menace is specific to Star Wars, but in this case, I think it could apply to the horde of batshit crazy fans of the Netflix series Arcane. My crime? I said it was boring. I had an opinion. I thought the internecine Intel and AMD fanboy wars were bad, but to have torched the League of Legends sycophants who breathlessly masturbate over its IP, well, that was a new experience. The reaction to my Arcane musings was a cesspool of insanity and people with real emotional issues. However, I would like to say that those of you who wrote thoughtful rebuttals, they were appreciated, and I tried to respond to all that I could. Thank you. Let me lay out the scenario. I recently did a short impressions review of Arcane, an animated series. I love animation, and I was eager to watch it. The animation was spectacular. The characterizations and voice work were excellent. All things I mentioned in my original post, but I still found it boring. And for reasons I'm not going to get into here. Okay, no, wait. I'll mention a couple of things later on. Here's the thing. I recorded that video for my usual suspects. Its purpose was not to antagonize Arcane's legion of fans. The thumbnail said, Arcane is boring. The title was, Arcane is boring, a review. Yet thousands of people did a hate watch and slammed me in the comments section. Clearly my review was shit because of all the flies it attracted. There were tons of ageist comments, because that's allowed. And there were tons of people saying the title was clickbait. No, YouTube clickbait is a title that misrepresents the content. For example, if your thumbnail proclaims bikini modeling video, but instead you show how to remove dried sewage from an RV's black tank, that's clickbait. Neither my thumbnail nor title were misleading. If you loved Arcane, there was nothing to compel you to click on my video. The first thing I said in the video was, Arcane is boring. You could have stopped the video right there, went on your merry way, and ended your self-induced trauma. My average viewing duration for my almost 500 videos is 70%. That's pretty good. For this Arcane video, it was hovering at around 23%. So clearly, most of you didn't even watch my post before commenting. Clearly, your critical powers are so highly evolved as to be able to judge something you didn't see, which is exactly what you accused me of, except I watched all of Arcane. So, you disagreed with my assessment. Good for you. Did we need to read your pathetic bleatings in responses? Sure, why not? I didn't block my comments. Social media is all about self-generating entertainment. So while you hated my thoughts on Arcane, you did love reading all the hate responses and personal insults directed towards me. So in that sense, you were entertained because of me. You're welcome. Before I get to just a sampling of some of the issues I had with the series, expanding on my previous video, which you said was inadequate, let me tell you a little bit about my background, because you all accused me of being a know-nothing. I've written, co-written, more than 120 scripts. I was head of TV comedy. I've read more than 1,200 sitcom scripts, spoken with hundreds of writers. I was even interviewing for a network job at Paramount when I decided I hated the biz and instead went off to explore my inner geek. Have you written or read that many scripts? Probably not. But here's the thing. None of that experience is particularly helpful when it comes to picking what will be a successful TV show or movie. I would like to point out that at no time did I say or imply that Arcane would not be successful or that it didn't deserve its success. There was a crap ton of work put into it. That was clear. You see, the thing is, all Hollywood cares about is success. How many Adam Sandler movies are well reviewed? Pretty much none of them. Yet his movies are some of the highest grossing. So, Arcane for me was a visual feast with a lot of groundbreaking animation pyrotechnics that in the end just left me cold. Okay, if I was the executive in charge of production, here would be a sampling of notes I would have given the creative team behind Arcane. One, Piltover is boring. It looks stunning in a kind of Kondo way. That was fine. No real complaints. Beautiful painting. Painterly effect there. But the council dialogue. Oh no, the trade portals will be disrupted. Wasn't that a line out of Star Wars, The Phantom Menace, speaking of? Dogman is stopping Square Jaw Boy and the Gimpy Leg Guy from making stuff with Hex Tech cuz something blah blah blah. Victor and Jace spend most of their time playing with their blue balls. And the highlight of Jace's arc, story arc, other than stooping Mel, who obviously helped him with his blue balls, was getting that old dog man, Heimerdinger, tossed from the council and replacing him. Oh my God, the tension was so thick you could cut it with a urine stream. Two, what bothered me most with this show was how often they chose to take motivation or agency away from characters. Some highlights. Jace should have personally dealt with the traitor Sheriff Marcus and not have him die in a hail of exploding bugs. In fact, one of the best scenes in the entire series was Vi and Jace fighting together after their effort to destroy a shimmer factory went awry. The scene was motivated by Vi wanting to hurt Silco. Vi and Jace were so good that I wished there were more scenes between them. Vi and Jace's split after the carnage was believable, and the monsters they were fighting turned out to be just kids in suits high on shimmer. That was very, very powerful. It had motivation, action, and consequences, and not just dialogue filled with emo melodramatic angst. I found the entire Caitlin springing Vi sequence from prison unsatisfying. Again, removing personal agency and consequences from Vi. The brief reconciliation between Vi and Jinx before the Firelighters attack was nice until Caitlin's appearance and Jinx accused Vi of being an upsider. If Vi herself had in fact agreed to work with Piltover to get back at Silco, it would have made for a much more powerful scene. Finally, one last small thing. Why at the end was it Caitlin who used the glass shard to cut her ropes and not Vi? Vi has some great fight scenes with Silco's henchperson, Savika, but she gets knocked out and carried away a lot. No one could accuse her of being a Mary Sue. Having Vi just sit there, tied up to the end, was wholly unsatisfying, as good as Jinx's monologue was, and it was fantastic. I'm sure I'm alone on this, But Silco never made it for me, even with that Roman Polanski thing he had with Jinx. Jinx killing him was an interesting twist, but also removed any kind of dramatic revenge option from Vi again, which might have been what the writers wanted. Still, it made for an unsatisfying ending for me. There you go. As I said earlier, I have learned that in social media, the comments section is its own entertainment forum. So have at it. I'd like to thank ahead of time all the people who choose to make respectful comments. I don't understand where the rudeness comes from. Perhaps some of you were dropped on your heads at birth. I don't know. Till next time, denizens. Be seeing you.